Hey guys, and welcome to Handlebar Risers and Highway Pegs on Your Motorcycle. We're going to go over five things. For each thing, for the handlebar risers and for the highway pegs, these little puppies, we're going to go over five things that are worth knowing and five things that are worth considering before you make the investment and buy these two added features to your motorcycle, whatever style motorcycle you ride. I've got a Triumph Speedmaster with me today, so I'm going to be going off what I have recently just purchased for my bike, but it applies to all motorbikes.
So guys, as we leave this beautiful location, things to consider for your handlebar risers and when you're getting your highway pegs, if that's what you like to call them, highway pegs, cruising pegs, generally highway pegs they're known as. But there are a few things you want to consider, and if we start off with number one, which is really worth thinking about, is what do you want them for? Are you in it for the comfort that the risers may give you and the pegs down here are going to give you? Are you in it for the looks, or are you simply just doing it because that's what you've heard can be good and other people are doing it and you don't really know why you're doing it? It's worth thinking about that before you spend your hard-earned cash on some risers or some forward foot pegs. That's number one starting point. Now, I'll just go over what I've got on my bike here on the Speedmaster. They're not big risers, they're just 1 inch. They're called 1 inch up and overs from a company in the UK called Motone. So they basically come up 1 inch, and as the name suggests, back 1 inch. So they're a little bit higher up for your hand position, and they're a little bit closer to me as well, so there's less stretching forward or leaning forward. It gives you much more of a comfortable, laid-back riding position. Now the pegs, there's a bit to consider with the pegs. I've got these. I actually bought them straight off of trusty old eBay, and they're just your simple bolt-on to the dresser bars at the front. You fold them out with your feet like so. And there you go, rest your feet forward. Okay, it's not perfect for country lanes like this, it's more meant for highway, as the name suggests again, for cruising. But it's just an option to be more comfortable, really. That is all they are. And I must say, they work. On longer rides, they're really good on the motorway. This is a very comfortable bike, the Speedmaster, like most Harley Davidsons and cruisers are, but if you're on the motorway for over a couple of hours, it is lovely to have that option with the four pegs to just change your leg position, whether it be stretching them right out, whether it be sort of just maybe just resting your one leg out like so. It really helps. I get a bit of a dodgy hip at my ripe old age, which is strange, but I find just perfect there. I can just fold out that left peg and rest my left leg, just straighten it out, and it just takes takes any load off of that leg just for a little bit, just to stretch your legs a bit. So the second major thing is it really is there mainly for comfort. That is why I bought them, and obviously it will change per motorcycle, and there's a variety of bar risers and pegs you can get, and everything's different, but I went in it for comfort. And I will say, this setup I have on this bike, it's definitely more comfortable than when I didn't have the risers or the pegs. It wasn't uncomfortable before, but it has improved the comfort by quite a bit, actually. So guys, the comfort is a major part for bar risers and the highway pegs, obviously. Probably being the main part, but I think another reason I got them as well to double up is the looks. You can really change the look of your bike with bar risers and the pegs. I mean,
these are small bar risers. You look at some of the Harley Davidsons, you go for massive mini ape hangers or huge bar risers to bring the bars right up, and that can actually potentially make the bike more uncomfortable. Yeah, so not in every instance it's not going to be more comfortable with the bar risers, so you've got to judge which ones you want, the dimensions of the risers, because it can affect other things than just comfort. The more you start stretching out the height of the bar risers, the more you're going to affect the dynamics of the bike, like the handling, etc. But back onto the looks, I just love the looks of the Speedmaster's quite a relatively flat bike profile along the top, I think I'd describe it as. And I wanted to bring the front end up a touch. And even just coming up an inch with those bar risers from Moto, and it's really helped with that look and give it a bit more of a sort of a slightly more chopper vibe to it. And then again on the looks, even with the foot pegs, there's such a variety of different foot pegs you can get. I went sort of mainly chrome because I like the chrome contrast with the black on this bike. But again with the looks, it just gives that front end a bit more of a beefy feel to it, which I really like. A beefier front end, skinnier rear end, excuse the pun. But yeah, it looks really nice. And also, you can fold them out like so, and they look really cool folded out. So this may seem fairly obvious, but actually quite an important thing to consider with your highway pegs or foot pegs is where are you going to attach them. Now some bikes may naturally have a place where you can attach them to, but a lot of bikes don't. For instance, on the Speedmaster here, you've got your exhaust headers, and then in front of them, this chrome bar, which is called a dresser bar. I actually had to fit this dresser bar to be able to attach the highway pegs to it. So just a point to think about before your highway pegs. Where can you fit them? Is there enough room? Do you need to buy something else to fit to your bike before you can fit the pegs on? Okay, we're going to go into another thing to consider with the highway pegs. Now they all look very nice there. If I just take my leg forward and fold them out, that's how they'll be when riding along. Now, I did have a bit of an issue. They may look all well and good there. If I put my foot on there, if you can see that. It's just a thing to consider. When you're fitting the pegs, my heel was touching the gear lever, which may seem like a neat little trick, but it's not. It wasn't meant to be like that. It could be if you constantly want to be changing down gear from on the pegs, but that's often not the case. It just gets a little bit annoying when your feet are resting on the highway pegs. If you haven't set your pegs to the right height or the right angle back and forwards as well, you may be knocking your heel on the gear lever, or same as on the right-hand side of the bike, the rear brake as well. So it's worth just considering that, how far back, forwards and backwards are the pegs going to be, and how high do you want them as well.
So once you've had a good think about the pegs there, back onto the handlebars. Obviously, make sure you get a set that are going to fit your bike specifically. All bikes are different, all handlebars are different, so do your research on that. If you own a Triumph Speedmaster, if you just so happen to, these Motone 1-inch up and overs are very good. They fit very well. I'm going to point you in the direction of another YouTube video, actually, for fitting instructions on them, if you're interested. He's called Stuart Fillingham. Very good. He does an instructional video of how to fit the Motone risers, and it's very good. I just followed his instructions, and all has worked very well. Now, changing your risers from stock to a custom fitting is very nice and makes your bike more unique, but even these, the 1-inch up and overs, it has affected the handling on my bike here. Like I said, it is a lot more comfortable for longer cruises and for highway cruising, but in the twisties, not too bad, but noticeably, even with just that small rise and it's more the back towards me, I can notice a slight negative effect to the handling. It's not quite as agile as it was before, which I think I'm completely happy with. There's always a compromise if you're going to start fitting new things to the handlebars, and I have lost a bit of agility and athleticism to this handling on the Speedmaster. But I've gained comfort and that more cruiser style look, which I was expecting, and I'm happy with that. But worth considering that before you choose your risers. Are you willing to compromise the handling of your motorcycle for perhaps not worse, but for a different feeling? That's definitely worth thinking about.
So guys, as we're getting closer, I've lost how many points we're on. Meant to be doing five, aren't we? But may go a little bit over. Another thing with onto the handlebar risers again. Whoa, it's got a lot of chrome there. Sorry about the sunglasses. Another thing with the handlebar risers is they can be a little bit fiddly to fit. It's not overly technical, but there's a few things you'll want to do your research into to fitting them before doing it. I'll just point out a couple of things on this specific bike, on the Triumph Speedmaster, that you will want to keep an eye out for, but you can also transfer it across to other bikes. For instance, a couple of the things I'm going to show you now will transfer onto other bikes that you will want to check will be okay with the specific handlebar risers that you get for those bikes as well. So apologies if you can't see that too well, but one main consideration is the length of your cables and wires that come up to your handlebars. For instance, the clutch lever, the brake, and any wiring going into your dash sort of cockpit area as well. So down here on the Triumph Speedmaster, come on camera, there you go. You've got all of these wires coming out here. Now if I was to fit the Mini Apes, which should have come, sorry about the camera work, come right up here really high, then you would have to change the cables out or get cable extensions to reach them. However, with these handlebars, these specific risers, as I say, it's only 1 inch, so it's fine. The cables are naturally long enough stock to reach onto the handlebars, but that is well worth considering. And when you do fit these handlebars, it's worth just loosening these cable tidies off so the cables have a little bit of play and can stretch a little bit. So another thing, guys, obviously you have your bolts holding your handlebars on, and for this specific bike you really want to get your Newton meters right. So you want a torque wrench and you want to get your Newton meters right. So I did my research. These four bolts with the clamps is 24 Newton meters. Then if we come up under, you have a bolt, one big bolt, you possibly won't be able to see it, apologies, but there's just a bolt there and one on the other side to clamp the risers down. That is 38 Newton meters of tension. So yeah, I'm no mechanic, but just a point you're going to want to take to think about and consider when doing your handlebars. It'll take a little bit of research just to make sure you get the right ones. It's not just buy one size fits all. It changes per bike and per handlebar risers.
I hope that was some useful, just a few little pointers on bar risers and highway pegs there. In conclusion, it's really thinking back to that first point, what do you want them for? Is it for comfort? Is it purely for looks? Or are you just doing it because you feel you should be doing something? It's worth always just sort of considering a few of those little points, which I've learned now from doing mine, before you make a decision on what you're going to get. Overall, I'm very pleased with mine, and that's the beauty about customising your motorcycle, is you can really make it unique and make it your own. I think highway pegs are great, very comfortable. I've got a few longer trips planned. I'm looking forward to using those. The bar risers may take a little bit of time to get used to, but so far I am pleased with them. Thank you very much for watching. Good luck with your decisions. This has been a good insight into handlebar risers and highway pegs for your motorcycle. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Ciao bella.